And Earlham education is important because I think Earlham produces curious, thoughtful people who want to make the world a better place. And I think that's partly why there's so many Earlhamites in DC, because I think Earlhamites hold themselves personally to very high standards, but they also look at things systemically. And they want to make change not just for themselves, but they want to make change at scale. My name is Carrie Seltzer. I graduated from Earlham in 2004, and now I work for iNaturalist, which is one of the world's largest biodiversity citizen science programs, and it's a joint initiative of the California Academy of Sciences and the National Geographic Society. iNaturalist is a platform, works on your phone, works on your computer, but I like to describe it as turning photos of plants and animals into useful scientific data through crowdsourcing. My role at iNaturalist is facilitating international collaborations in particular and other external collaborations. So iNaturalist now has about 21 million observations from around the world, and we have about 600,000 people who have contributed those observations. So you can use iNaturalist anywhere in the world, but we also have relationships in certain countries where you can have a more localized experience. So even before I visited Earlham, the things that I heard that I was really excited about was the equestrian program, the fact that they had a barn full of horses on campus and that it was run by students, so there was a lot of opportunity for involvement there. Another thing that I was really interested in was the Joseph Moore Museum, because given my interest in nature and biology, it was exciting that there was a natural history museum right on campus and all the opportunities that come along with that. And I was also really excited about the climbing wall, which was really new at the time, and the ultimate frisbee team. While I was a student, I committed to a lot of things. I still have this problem, right? I don't want to say no to anything that I love and am excited about. So at Earlham, I was involved in the barn program. I was a member of barn staff. I also was on the equestrian team for my first 2 years at Earlham. As a member of barn staff, as the director of the barn specifically, I helped manage the barn's budget. That year we were able to balance that budget, but I was responsible for like ordering the food and making sure that we always had enough hay and shavings and feed for all of the horses, among many other things. So that was a very practical, real world responsibility, and I think a really unusual experience that a lot of folks don't necessarily get in college. I think my Earlham education allowed me to grow into my true self. I didn't feel like I had to pretend to be someone who I wasn't. And that for me was an incredible sort of personal awakening. I think I didn't realize until probably the end of my first year at Earlham how emotionally unhealthy I was in a lot of ways in high school. I went to a really excellent suburban public high school, but that classroom experience wasn't the same. It didn't have the same kind of close relationship with faculty or collaborative learning environment with my peers. I give back to Earlham in a lot of ways because I feel like Earlham gave so much to me. And I want to help other people have that same experience. You know, I think there's a lot of folks out there who would be a great fit for Earlham, and maybe they just haven't heard about it yet. And so I want to do whatever I can to help people find their place at Earlham, if it's the kind of place where they're going to blossom and reach their potential like I feel I did.